In this example problem, we're going to look for the cross slope in a horizontal curve at specific ranges of cross slope. So in our problem statement, we're told that to coordinate with the project's hydraulics engineering team, for the curve with a PI at station 57 plus 62.70, we need to provide the range of stations where the cross slope is less than or equal to 1%. This is our project. I'm specifically zooming in on the curve of interest. And it's actually split on two sheets. So I've matched up these two sheets here, and we'll dive into a little more detail with these, but we can see it's a horizontal curve, fairly long horizontal curve, and we want to focus on the places where the cross slope is equal to or less than 1%. We're given some basic curve information on the project design sheets. And we also, importantly, it's helpful to look for the distance to change 1% in cross slope, and that's given as 20.84 feet. So looking at this a little more closely so we can see the detail here, here's the location. We actually can see it on the design plans where we're less than or equal to 1% on the PC side of the curve, and then also on the PT side of the curve, we can see the range of values we're looking for. And we know those distances actually is 20, each of the 1% ranges is 20.84, so we have two of those distances on each side of the curve, and we'll see that come into play as we look at the profile view of the curve and lay out how that curve is changing, the cross slope is changing throughout this horizontal curve. So we'll use a profile view and looking at the relative gradient for the inside and outside edge of pavement relative to that center line. We're going to plug in the values that we know for this particular curve. We're given the PC and the PT stations from our design plans. So the PC is at station 53 plus 48.44. The PT is station 61 plus 19.37. And we have a design super elevation of 4%. We were told from our design plans that a 1% change in super elevation occurs in a distance of 20.84 feet. And so we can calculate our runoff, super elevation runoff. It's going to take us 4%. And so that distance is going to be 4 times 20.84. For a runoff of 83.36 feet. And so now we have those values. We also can find our tangent runout, and that's our normal crown of 2% divided by our design super elevation multiplied by the runoff. So it's 2% divided by 4% multiplied by 83.36 feet. So all we're doing is taking the half of that runoff in this particular case. So we have 41.68 feet for our tangent run out. Now we can start looking at where is the cross slope going to be less than or equal to one, and actually is going to, we're not going to have any value that's lower than 1% from halfway between B and C to halfway between points F and G. So I'm shading that out in red, and we can actually look and see that for the inside edge of pavement, we never have a cross slope that is less than 2%. So really we're focused on the outside edge of pavement here. And we also, halfway between A and B, we're not gonna be, and before that, we're not gonna be less than 1%. And then the same thing on the other side of the curve. So these small kind of areas without the cross hatching or the stationing that we're looking for this particular curve. And again, in particular, where the outside edge of pavement is going to be less than or equal to 1%. Because it's each side of those is half of the tangent runout, the distance there is 41.68 feet. And now starting with B, we can find the stationing of point B by subtracting off 2/3 of the runoff from the PC. So 53 plus 48.44. Minus 2/3 of 83.36 feet gives us a station of B of 52 plus 92.87. Now on the earlier side, the left side of the 1%, that's going to be half of that tangent runout distance. So 52 plus 92.87 minus 1/2 of 41.68 gives us a beginning station where we first are hit 1% of 52 plus 72.03. And on the other side of this 1% area, 52 plus 92.87 plus 1/2 of 41.68 feet gives us a station of 53 plus 13.71. And so now we have that range of stations that's equal to or less than 1% in the cross slope. On the right side of the curve now for point B, we have a station, we're going to add 2/3 of the runoff to the PT, so 61 plus 19.37 plus 2/3 of 83.36 feet gives us a station of point G of 61 plus 74.94. On the left side of this range, we're going to subtract off half of that TRO, so 61 plus 74.94 minus 1/2 of 41.68. gives us a station of 61 plus 54.1. And the right side of that range, we're going to add half of the TRO. So we have 61 plus 74.94 plus 1/2 of 41.68 gives us a station of 61 plus 95.78. So our final answer for this question, where is the cross slope less than or equal to 1% for this particular curve? And that's from station 52 plus 72.03 to station 53 plus 13.71. And on the other side of the curve, 61 plus 54.1 to station 61 plus 95.78.